With a coronavirus vaccine on the way and many students still learning from home, in a new FoxNews.com op-ed, our next guest says governors should give teachers priority for COVID-19 vaccinations so schools can reopen. Joining me now is nationally syndicated columnist Adriana Cohen. Good morning, Adriana. So lay out for us why it is teachers should move to the front of the line and be prioritized in getting a vaccine, please.
Absolutely, because millions of America's children are suffering, being isolated at home, cut off from their peers, from teachers, from their schools. With schools closures, we have millions of American children who are, you know, staring at computer screens all day. This has taken an enormous toll on them, physically, mentally, and academically. If you look at mentally how it's affecting them, mental illness is up in children ages 5 through 17. The CDC reports there's been a 31% increase in emergency department visits at hospitals for kids suffering from mental illness since April. This is a catastrophe. Secondly, you have the issue of failing grades. All over the United States, we're seeing a number of students dropping out of school because virtual learning isn't working for them. Here in Massachusetts, over 37,000 students have dropped out of the public school system this year. In Los Angeles, in the largest school district there, 11,000 students have dropped out. We're seeing similar dropouts in North Carolina, Utah, Washington, D.C. And then if you look at the grades are in because we've already got the first report card in from the first semester for school. There's been a massive increase in students, middle schoolers and high school students, who are failing school. Right. This is totally unacceptable. It's a national health crisis, and we need to get kids back into the classroom.
I agree, Adriana. While that has been discussed, I'm not sure we've done much more than give lip service to the costs on that side of this equation. You brought up dropouts. I'd love to show you this map. This is a map of school districts reporting a decline in public school enrollment over the last year. You can see it's 21 different states have public school districts who have reported a drop in enrollment. What do you think, Adriana, is the teachers' unions, various teachers' unions' perspective on this? Do they agree with you? Do they want their teachers to be moved to the front of the line and prioritized when it comes to getting the vaccine?
Well, I would hope so, because their reasoning for keeping schools closed is because they didn't want to have teachers exposed to children possibly bringing COVID into the school system and affecting them. Well, one way to solve that problem is to get teachers vaccinated. The vaccines are reportedly 95% effective. They're reportedly very safe, so there's no reason why teachers shouldn't be demanding this vaccine. If they don't want it, then that raises eyebrows. People are going to start to wonder, was this all political or was this truly about science? Because if the vaccine is good enough for doctors and our frontline workers, it should be good enough for our teachers. And so governors right now need to prioritize the teachers. They're essential workers, and we need to get our kids back into the classroom because, you know, let's also look at the fact that kids being sedentary, staring at computer screens 6 hours or 8 hours a day at home, this is causing an increase in diabetes and obesity and other, you know, health problems. It's just a catastrophe, and it's been going on since last March. This is not like a two-week thing. This has been going on for 8 months now.
You know, and the science suggests that kids are not spreading it to each other, that schools aren't big spreader points, and the kids aren't spreading it to adults even in a school environment. Right. So I don't know that we are going to follow the science. We haven't yet to this point. But there is no doubt schools should be open. Adriana, thanks so much for sharing your perspective this morning. All right. All right, still ahead.